comes the problem of high costs for commodities.
Yesterday evening, President Yoweri Museveni addressed the country on the current economic crisis characterized by escalating prices of fuel and other essential commodities. The president made it clear that the government will not make any tax waiver for imported commodities to mitigate the crisis. Museveni advised Ugandans to instead be frugal with the local resources to manage the situation, which is hitting the whole world in equal measure.
These producers of palm oil, I hear that they have started converting it into petroleum. Some of the ideas people think about when confronted with high commodity prices are the idea of subsidy. Government okutukwatirako or removal of taxes by government from those commodities. With imported commodities, this is a recipe for disaster. It will lead to collapse of the economy.
Today, a section of members of parliament have applauded the president for speaking out on the matter, which other government agencies had failed to explain and created an impression that the government was not concerned on the matter. MPs believe that since the economic crisis is not only in Uganda, reducing taxes on fuel alone cannot do much.
Because we depend on taxes. Now if you say that we totally remove all the taxes from the imported products, where will you survive from? We still need services. Much as some commodities prices are high, but still we need now to learn on how we can be in position to live with the prevailing situations.
Taxes on essential commodities are already not there on essential commodities. So I agree with the president that it would be very suicidal, but I think that as government, we need to use this as a learning experience. Like if our people are mainly depending on agriculture, then irrigation farming is the way to go.
Although they welcomed the call for frugality, legislators have challenged the president to practice the frugality he preached yesterday by taming government's excessive expenditure.
I agree with the president that we need to be frugal. But you know, you can only become frugal if you have something. You can use something sparingly if you have it.
Patrick Katabazi, the Executive Director, Center for Budget and Tax Policy, joined MPs to laud President Museveni for addressing the country with honesty on the current economic situation and suggesting practical solutions that are not politically motivated.
For me, I think the President's address is very important, for it assures the nation that, first of all, the President and government is in charge. Secondly, that the government cares.
Katabazi has however called on government to advance better policies for import substitution and export promotion to boost local manufacturers to produce competitive products.
In some cases, we prefer things that are imported, yet ordinarily we could support our locally produced goods. So if we do that, my thinking is that I would have supported our local industries.
However, some legislators have punched holes in President Museveni's take on the current economic situation, saying he did not satisfy Ugandans who rested their hope in him to move the country out of the crisis. The
president was not well briefed, and I think we need to cause a meeting with the president to let him know the real status of the poor. It seems he's living in another world, and the people are also living in another world.
So that is a lie. So I think we needed a better and elaborate approach on first of all, how we can control and deal with inflation. Now someone, a person, a typical Ugandan has to move with a sack of money to buy a simple bar of soap. So essential commodities and their prices are escalating. There are no solutions being offered.
At the time when he's telling us to be frugal, he should have stopped by not taking money for classified. And we say, this financial year, we can save the 2 trillion he always takes to buy guns. Why would he buy guns now when people are in problems?
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.